Hey everyone, today's video is going to be a review on my favorite face product today, which is the NARS Sheer Glow Foundation in the color Tahoe. As you guys probably know, I've been using Sheer Matte. Ooh, my hair's sticking out. I've been using Sheer Matte. I used that all throughout the summer and it was a great product, but I used that when I was a little bit more tanned. That color no longer suits me, so I had to change my foundation colors. I thought I would go for the Sheer Glow instead because I found a great primer that really helps with oily skin. So, I mean, these days oily skin is not my biggest concern, so I can use foundations that are not meant for oily skin and still, you know, my face will look fine. It won't look like a grease pan after a few hours. So, this is what the packaging looks like. It is a square bottle. The top, when you open this, you just do that, and it's like a round top. And this is one fluid ounce, which is a lot of product. So this product is $42 at Sephora. I don't know where else you can buy this, but $42 is a lot for a foundation. But if the foundation, there's so much in here, like it's gonna last you forever. Especially because this foundation is so super blendable that you don't need very much. Foundations that are harder to blend, you end up using so much more product because you'll put it on your cheek and it only blend a little bit. So you have to add some more product for every other part of your face. With this, I just use one pump and it's enough for my whole face, which is kind of crazy. I don't know why I just said pump though, because I did not buy the pump that you can buy with this. It's $7 at Sephora and I thought that was just too much for a pump and that would make this foundation almost $50. So I've just been opening it and doing that and, you know, getting product out that way, which isn't the easiest way to do it, I will have to say, but it's not too bad. Once it really gets down to about halfway or whatever, then I might get a pump, but as of right now, it's not a huge necessity. Now, this foundation was marketed towards dry to normal skin, and I will say that it probably isn't a good foundation to use for oily skin. The reason being, if you don't have a good primer that really helps keep your oil at bay, you will probably get oily within, I would say, an hour and a half of using this product, which is not something you want, especially if you have oily skin. So if you have not found a good primer, I would say stay away. However, if you have normal to dry skin, this is a great product. It makes your skin look really dewy, really natural, and not like a crazy amount of coverage, which I like. Now, if you have like a lot of acne or whatever, this might not be the best product for you. It says that it is buildable, but I don't think it's excessively buildable. For instance, the coverage is medium. It's not very light. It's not very dark, or I mean not dark, heavy, but the more you add on, you know, product to your face, this ends up looking really thick. And then it's not worth it because it ends up looking like you're wearing so much makeup that it doesn't look good. So in that case, if you want really heavy coverage, I would go for another brand like Makeup Forever or something like that. And just get a heavy coverage foundation from them and just stick to that one instead of having to layer this one. That's just my opinion though. This one is in the color Tahoe. They have a really good shade range, especially for my skin type and or skin color, because they have a lot of colors that are really good for darker skin. Even for lighter skin, they have amazing colors. The one thing that I really like is that these colors, this one has some pink to this because my skin actually is an NW, but I tend to use cool colors instead because I wanted to like even out the pink in my skin. So it's one of those foundations that you can do that with. You don't have to necessarily get the perfect match for it to look good. If you use like a MAC foundation or even Makeup Forever, it tends to be harder to do that. You have to find a perfect match or else it won't work. So in that regard, this foundation is really good. You don't have to get the perfect color. For instance, this color is actually a little bit too dark for me. This is a good color for my chin and my forehead, but it's not a very good color for my cheeks because I'm a little bit too light for this. However, when I blend it in and use a little product, it looks really natural. So that's a huge plus for me, you know, who wouldn't want a color that you can wear all throughout the year and just blend it a little more to make it look really good. Also, the word sheer in this is a little bit misleading. When it says sheer glow, that doesn't mean that the glow, or I mean that doesn't mean that it's sheer coverage. It just means that the glow that it gives you is sheer. It's not like, it's not gonna make your skin look oily, but it's not gonna make it look matte either. The same thing goes for the sheer matte. It's not saying that your coverage is sheer, it's just saying that the matte finish of it is sheer. It's not like excessively matte like the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Plus or anything like that. So that's a little bit misleading, but All in all, this foundation is really good. Worn with the primer that I wear it with, this foundation will last up to 12 to 15 hours, which is kind of crazy. It doesn't slide off my face even though I'm oily, and it looks really natural. When I wear this, people have given me compliments on my skin, saying that your skin looks so good, and what's better than a compliment on your skin, you know, because that means that the person thinks that you're not wearing makeup and that your skin is just naturally beautiful. So in general, I would say even if you are oily, try, like, invest more time and effort into finding a good primer and then leave your matte foundations behind and kind of go into something that's a little bit more dewy. It makes you look a whole lot more natural and makes your skin look three-dimensional. I noticed in so many of my pictures, you know, back in the day, I was so obsessed with, like, matte everything because I thought that if I had a little bit of shine on my face, it would just transform into oil and look terrible. But I saw in pictures that I just started looking so two-dimensional, and it didn't look like my skin was glowing or anything like that. It just made it look really flat and old, because you guys all know that as you age, your skin tends to get dry. I don't think you ever met, like, a 40-year-old or 50-year-old with, you know, really oily skin. And when your skin, you know, so it's like drying skin is kind of something that happens to older people. So if you don't want to look that way, then you should try to keep your skin as youthful and natural and glowing and healthy as possible. Also, I have used this along with a luminizer, and that was just too much because this has such a natural, pretty sheen of its own that I wouldn't use this in conjunction with a luminizer. A luminizer such as Strobe Cream by MAC or the Stila highlighting thing, or there's so many out there. You know, you name a brand, they probably have one. But I also use this powder with the MAC Mineralized Skin Finish in Natural, and they look amazing together because Mineralized Skin Finish has a little bit of shine as well, so it does a good job of, like, powdering my face and keeping my oil at bay as well as adding a natural shine, you know, so it doesn't look like a matte powder, which is really good. Besides that, this foundation is kind of pricey, but I think that it's well worth it. It gives a beautiful finish. The color choices are just amazing. You know, I would really say, regardless of what color you are, they probably have a foundation to suit you, which is pretty impressive. I've yet to meet a makeup line that does that, you know. I would say MAC has the most impressive number of colors, but they don't really match skin types as well as NARS does. That's my review. I hope you guys found this helpful, and if you have any other questions, feel free to ask, and I will definitely get back to you. Bye, guys.